Welcome to another inspiring message with Pastor Deborah Bell from Deo Gloria, South Africa, as she brings you a word from God.
When your dreams are shattered, whoever you are, what do? You turn to say we've said it these days. Get rid of your wife, woman. Not so, she says. I am a woman who's deeply troubled. I mean, how dare you say I'm drunk? I'm praying. How many people know that word drunk comes in chapter 2, where we read that the Holy Spirit fell on the people, the flames of fire fell on the people, and it says that the guys turned around that were there around, and they said, listen, what's going on? It's only 9 o'clock in the morning. How can these people be drunk? They said they were drunk. And he turns around and says, listen, they're not drunk.
Don't give up on praying. Don't give up because you think that God has not come.
God today. Because I can tell you, put it on the other way. Been for a while in my life. And I thank God that I found the truth, the life, and the joy that only Jesus Christ can give. There's nothing like Christ. There's nothing like serving God. Don't give up. Keep persevering so that you can build your dream again. Mothers, are you hearing me? Mothers, say hi. Mothers, say amen. Are there any mothers out there? Mothers, say amen.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, I'm building my dream. You don't have to just be a good mother. Tell your neighbor, I'm building my dream.
I'm building my dream.
Tell me this. If you think God hasn't answered you and God is a parent and God created us and understands parenthood because all of it emanates from God, tell me this. If you reach out to God and cry out to God, your heavenly parent, would God's love propel God to help you or shun you? When your child comes to you and cries out to you for help, will you help your child or shun your child? I raise my hands. There's a story that's told of a family who remember very clearly the time that they gave their two-year-old son Steve his very first responsibility. They told Steve, little Stevie, to watch Susan, his baby sister. When he stepped out of the room, the father, he had only been gone a few minutes, when he heard a thump, and then Susan started crying. He rushed back to find that Susan had fallen from the couch and was stretched out on the floor. Meanwhile, Steve, little Stevie, just sat there looking so innocent. The parents said, Steve, I told you to watch her. Stevie answered, I did. He watched her fall. He watched her cry. He did exactly what he was told to do. Being a parent isn't easy. And sometimes it's filled with joy. And sometimes with sadness. And sometimes your children make you so proud that you want to pop your buttons. If you're a woman, be careful about that. At other times, you can't find enough handkerchiefs to dry your tears. But what good is it if your children are successful in making money, driving fine cars, living in good neighborhoods, but they don't know God, friends? Doesn't matter. The Bible says, what good is it if they gain the whole world but lose their souls? How many of you are praying for your families? How many of you are praying for your children to know the Lord Jesus Christ? How many of you are teaching in prayers and God-based teaching through the Bible? Hey, don't give up on praying for your children because they are going to make mistakes. They have to live it out for themselves. You can inform them about the mistakes you've made, but you've got to let them live out their own. Amen?
Yeah.
And then hopefully learn by their own. You can't live their lives for them, but you can pray for them and let them grow their character through making their mistakes and learning from them. Pray for the salvation of their souls and don't give up. And spouses, don't give up. Last point, number three. Hannah took time to pray. Hannah took time to pray. When your dreams are shattered, you're more open to taking time to pray. Amen? How many know that? When you just don't have anywhere else to go, where do you go? Where do you go? When you just have no other point A or B or C to go to and you've got to Z, where do you go? Here's what Hannah did. The first place she went. How many of us want to follow that? The first place we must go is to God. Don't make God your last stop. Take time to pray. When your dreams are shattered, you might be more open to wanting to speak to God. But we're too busy to pray. And as parents and mothers, sometimes prayer is the last thing you can think of when you've got screaming kids and teenagers that are breaking out in pimples, and you've got all sorts of school uniforms, you've got pregnancies to worry about, you've got grandkids just about coming along, you've got weddings, you've got everything happening at once. And you say, Lord, you have to. How am I supposed to find time to pray? I mean, Lord, you know what's going on. I mean, you created this whole thing. Tell me how to deal with it. But yeah, we need to pray. We need to actually make the time. Because when you make time to pray, when you take the time and you say, Lord, I'm putting you first in every single thing. As a mother, if you say, Lord, you know what, I'm getting up that 15 or 20 minutes or half an hour, 30 minutes extra to read my word, to hear from you, to pray. I know that things will work out in that day better. How many have tried that and seen it happen? That's what God wants you to do. You know, the thing is, we don't come to God first, so because we don't take time to pray. We let everything fall around us, crash around us, and when everything's all fall down, then we come to the Lord and say, Lord, help me. The Lord's saying, you know what, if you'd come to me in the first place, I could have sorted this mess out before everything fell apart. Amen?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. So don't do it the other way around. Do it the way Hannah did it. Come to the Lord first. We sometimes say to the Lord, I've got more important things to worry about. And not meaning that we're trying to disregard God, but you know, there are things in your family, you know, as a mother, you take priority, that's it, it's my family. The psalmist said, be still and know that I'm God. And so we have to hear what the psalmist said in 46:10, we've got to really take hold of the word. Don't give up. Include praying, because the important things in your life, as mothers, as parents, as friends, as family of God, pray. Mothers pray for their children to be saved. They pray for their children to live for the kingdom. They pray for their children to build the kingdom. Mothers, don't give up praying. The hymn writer put it like this: I must tell Jesus all of my trials. I cannot bear these burdens alone. In my distress, God kindly will help me. God ever loves and cares for God's own. John Stiles had this to say about prayer. I've worshipped in churches and chapels. I've prayed in the busy streets. I've sought my God and have found God in the waves of the ocean beat. I have knelt in the silent forest in the shade of some ancient tree, but the dearest of my altars was at my mother's knee. And then he says, God, make me the man of her vision and purge me of my selfishness. Yeah, you know, I think when we become adults and we, it's so weird, you know, it's kind of like we wake up, we almost are, you know, in our whole midlife crisis thing before we realize just how important our mothers are and the role that they've played. And I know that some of us haven't always had a good deal, but you know what? You're Christians. If you haven't let those bitter roots go, now's the time. I speak to you as children tonight, not just parents. So God heard and answered Hannah's prayer in a wonderful way. All at the end of the story, soon she had a son born to her. She was barren, but God gave her Samuel. And then she had other kids after that, by the way. And Hannah's outcome for you and I, can I ask the man to come up? It's not a secret formula. It's a simple life's lesson. Her dream was shattered, but she continued to travail. She continued to hang in there. And I want to tell you right now that Samuel went on to become this amazing, amazing prophet. I mean, he led the greatest and first revival and took the Philistines back into their territory and set up the kingdom of Israel and so on. And he even anointed David. And that was all because of Hannah's prayer of obedience and trusting God and persevering, knowing that God would come through for him. So I want you to stand with me right now. Let me ask you tonight, firstly, maybe all the mothers there, just if I can ask you this, have your dreams been shattered? Have your dreams been pulled? And if they have, I want to ask you this question, do you dare to dream again? Do you dare to dream again? Because this is your time, this is your season. You know, sometimes mothers spend so much effort and energy on their children, that they forget about themselves. And mothers, tonight and today, this is your day. This is a dedication to you. And I want to say, you dare to dream again, because you have a life as well. You know, you can be a good mother and still have your own life. You know that. Amen? So don't be in bondage about that. Deprive yourself of a life because you think you can't have a life if you have your kids. As in, your own identity, as in, experiencing and sharing your own joy, having a wonderful time in your life, not just thinking that if your focus is on you for a minute and not on your kids, that you're not being a good mother. Amen. Please help us to say amen. If you're mother or not, please say amen. I want you to not only forgive anything in your own parents' life, mothers, that have hurt you tonight, but I also want you to forgive yourselves. I want you to lay to rest any of your own guilt that has transpired from anything in your life that has stopped you living your dream. And that has stopped you daring to dream. And tonight we're going to say, Lord, I'm daring to dream again. I'm daring to dream. I'm daring to... some of you have forgotten about who you even are. You've just spent your whole lives. And it's wonderful to have taken care of your kids. But you know what? You have to take care of yourself too. You have to dream. You have to hold your dream and lift it to life. It doesn't matter how old you are, how young you are, or where you are on the scale of parenthood. Mothers, do you dare to dream again? And as you put your hands up right now, and as your eyes are closed, everyone, I pray right now, an anointing and a release of every chain being broken over every mother here tonight. Lord, that their dreams would be explosive, that they would arise, Lord, from every pit and every dominion of guilt and every other thing that they've been putting under the sun and that has come upon their lives, Lord, that they would be released into being able to live in their dream, to build that, Lord, from this point on, and release every bit of guilt and every bit of hurt and everything else that they've gone through as mothers to you tonight.
You've been watching Pastor Deborah Bell from Gloria, South Africa.